11th standard, exercise 1.2, problem number 9. In the set integer, in the set of Z integer, define M related to N. M related to N, if M minus N is divisible by 7, prove that R is an equivalent relation. Clear that? So what is the relation? Relation is M related to M is a relation, and condition mean M minus N is divisible by 7. M minus N is divisible by 7. It is condition, relation where M and N are set of all integers. Where M and N are set of all integers, prove that R is an equivalent relation. It's clear that we see the solution. So given, what is given? So given data is M and N are integer for all. For all M comma N belongs to Z. It is meaning that for all M comma N belongs to Z. Z means integer. So integers start with from integers start with from 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3 etc. plus or minus infinity. This is set of all integers. So this one is given data. Again, what is the relation? The relation is M related to N. M related to N, then condition. Third one is condition. What is condition? M minus N is divisible by 7. M minus N is divisible by 7. So what is proof? To prove R is an equivalence relation. R is an equivalent relation. So clear that first one is Z is set of all integer, M related to M, M minus N is divisible by 7 is condition. Prove that R is an equivalent relation. Clear that? So first one, what is equivalent relations? Equivalent relation is nothing but so R is an equivalent relation. So equivalent relation meaning that the equivalent relation is nothing but satisfies reflexive, symmetry and transitivity property. So first one is reflexive. First one is reflexive. What is reflexive? The basic definition for reflexive, M comma M belongs to R. For all M belongs to Z. It is meaning that all pair of basic definition M comma M belongs to R. For all M belongs to Z. So relation. The relation is M related to M. M related to M. Condition. What is condition? M minus M is divisible by 7. It is condition. So this condition satisfies this number or not? We have to check in M minus M. Let us take for any number in Z. So first one is 0. 0 minus 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. Divisible by 7 equal to 0. So M minus M. Let's take another number. 1 minus 1 equal to 0 by 7 equal to 0. 2 minus 2, 3 minus 3, minus 1 to minus 1 to minus 1. So minus of minus 1 plus 1 equal to 0 by 7. Take any number in integers where satisfies this condition. M minus M, M 3 minus 3, 4 minus 4, minus 4, minus of minus 4 plus 4. So satisfies divisible by condition 7. So clearly M minus M is divisible by 7 is true. So hence it is reflexive. It is reflexive. First one is. Second condition is symmetric. Second condition, symmetric. the basic definition for symmetry, A comma B. So M comma N and M comma M belongs to integer. It is basic definition for symmetry. Relation. What is relation? The relation is M related to N and N related to M. M related to N and N related to M. So condition. What is condition? M minus N is divisible by 7 and N minus M. N minus M is divisible by 7. It is clear that both conditions. Let's check it. This is true or false. First one is take any two number M minus N. So 3 minus 10. 3 minus 10 equal to minus 7. Divisible by 7 is minus 1. So 3 minus 10 is minus 1. So 10 minus 3. 10 minus 3 also 7. Divided by 7 equal to 1. It is also divisible by 7. So any number will take 1 minus 8. 1 minus 8 equal to minus 7. Divided by 7 equal to minus 1. 8 minus 1 equal to 7 by 7 equal to 1. So all number satisfies this condition. M minus N and N minus N. M minus N, M minus N. It is clear that so M minus N divisible by 7 and also N minus N divisible by 7. Hence it is symmetry. It is symmetric because this is the condition. Third one is transitive. Transitive. So basic definition for transitive. Take any three number. The basic definition for transitive, M comma N and N comma L belongs to R, which implies M comma L belongs to R. It is clear that. So the first one is relation. So what is relation? M related to N comma N related to L and M related to L. So both are satisfies this condition or not, we check it. So condition 1, first condition is M minus N divisible by 7. Second one, N minus L divisible by 7. Third one, third condition also M minus L divisible by 7. We check it. This condition of true or false. So first one is take any three number. For example, take any three number. 1 minus 8. 1 minus 8 means M minus L. 8 minus 22. 1 minus 8, it is minus 7. 8 minus 22, it is minus 14. It is clear that 8 minus 22, minus 14. Then 1 minus 22. 1 minus 22, it is minus 21. Both number are divisible by 7. It is clear that M minus N, N minus L, therefore M minus L. It is clear that using this condition M comma N, this means M minus N divisible by 7. So M minus N, this one is M minus N, M minus 1. 1 minus 8 divisible by 7. So first condition true. Second one is N minus L. N minus L. 8 minus 22. 8 minus 22 minus 14 divided by 7. N minus L is also true. Third one is 1 minus 22. 1 minus 22 meaning that M minus L. It is also minus 21 divided by 7 equal to 3. Therefore, it is also divisible by 7. Clear that? So take any number, for example 3 minus 10. Another one example for take any 3 number for this relation. 10, 3 minus 10. 3 minus 10 minus 7, divisible by 7, m minus n. Second one is 10 minus 31. 10 minus 31 mean 10 minus 31 minus 21. Minus 21 divisible by 7. Third one is 3 minus 31. 3 minus 31 means minus 28. It is also divisible by 7. So all pair, take any pair of this relation in set of all integer, we have satisfies divisible by 7, m minus n, n minus n, and also m minus n. Hence it is transitive. Therefore it is transitive. It is transitive. Therefore the given relation, therefore the relation, the relation R is an equivalent relation. The relation R is an equivalent relation. So exercise 1.2 is completed for this problem. The remaining two problems are your assignment problem. Exercise 1.2 completed. Thank you for watching. Next exercise for next class.